Going to start with the capital and revenue transaction. Why we are learning about capital and revenue transaction? Look at the board. The lifeblood of any business is cash. The lifeblood of any business is cash. The cash may be inflow of cash and outflow of cash. The lifeblood of any business is cash. It may be inflow of cash or outflow of cash. Okay. Inflow of cash is nothing but receipts, called cash receipts. Outflow of cash called payments, cash payments. Okay, students. The lifeblood of any business is cash. The cash may be inflow of cash or outflow of cash. Inflow of cash we can say receipts. Outflow of cash we can say payments. Okay. If we start business for one day, so all inflow of cash called receipt, all inflow of cash called receipt, considered as revenue, income. All outflow of cash considered as expenses. Students, listen carefully. If we start business for one day or for one year, all cash inflow considered as income, all cash payment considered as expenses. Here there is no assets and liabilities because the life of business is very short, one day or for one year. Normally every business concern started to run for very long period of time under going concern concept. Though we are running business for the long period of time, we have to prepare accounts every year. So that cash inflow may be associated with the current year as well as to the subsequent years. Likewise, the cash outflow related to the current accounting period as well as subsequent accounting period. So the need for study about the capital and revenue transaction arise. Now we'll learn about capital and revenue transaction. Look at the board. The inflow of cash, earlier I said inflow, outflow. Inflow we can call it as receipts, outflow we can call it as payments. Here we are going to run business for the long period of time, so that receipts and payment not only related to the current accounting period but also it relate to the subsequent accounting period. So the need for capital and revenue transaction arose. Okay, now the payment. Today we are going to study about payment. The payment we can call capital expenditure. We can call capital expenditure, deferred revenue expenditure. One more we have called revenue expenditure. When we operate business for long period of time, in that time we have to classify our payment into three categories. One is capital expenditure, another one is deferred revenue expenditure, the third one is revenue expenditure. What is capital expenditure? Capital expenditure is an expenditure which is non-recurring in nature. Incurred to increase the profit earning capacity of the business. Profit earning capacity of the business. Students, listen carefully. Capital expenditure, which is non-recurring in nature, which is incurred to increase the profit-earning capacity of the business, it has useful years of life. It has useful years of life. Fourth one, it intended to benefit for several accounting periods. Say for example, 3 to 10 years. So we can use its benefit for several accounting period, not only for the current accounting period. So capital expenditure is a non-recurring in nature, which incurred to increase the profit earning capacity of the business. It has useful years of life. It intended to benefit for several accounting periods, say 3 to 10 years. Then after its useful life it possesses a scrap value. It possesses a scrap value or turn-in value or residual value. Students, now I'm going to give you examples on capital expenditure. Here I'm going to write capital expenditure. One, purchase of fixed asset. Two, purchase of second hand fixed asset. Three, purchase of second hand. Then amount spent in order to get license. Fourth one, renewal of license. Then overhauling expenses. Then purchase of intangible assets such as goodwill, patent, trademark, copyright, purchase of intangible fixed asset. 7-1, increase in seating capacity. Increasing in seating capacity in cinema theater. Increasing cinema theater seating capacity. Next, construction of temporary huts. Next, carriage expenses incurred for purchase of fixed asset. Carriage expenses incurred in order to purchase fixed asset. Next, 10th one, legal expenses incurred for purchase of fixed assets. One, wages paid for the construction of building. 12, wages paid for the installation of machinery. Amount spent in order to rainwater harvesting system 14 replacement of petrol driven engine by diesel driven engine 15 replacement of petrol driven engine by diesel driven engine next extension of buildings replacement of important component in the machinery. Students, I gave few example for capital expenditure, namely purchase of fixed asset, purchase of second hand fixed asset, amount spent in order to get license, renewal fee for license, overhauling expenses for second hand asset purchased, purchase of intangible assets such as goodwill, patent, trademark, copyright, increasing in seating capacity in the cinema theater, construction of temporary huts. Before construction of building, we have to spend for construction of huts, temporary huts. That expenditure treated as a capital expenditure. Carriage expenses incurred for the purchase of fixed asset, legal expenses incurred for purchase of fixed asset, wages paid for the construction of building, wages paid for the installation of machinery, amount spent in order to rainwater harvesting system, replacement of petrol driven engine by diesel driven engine, extension of building, replacement of important component in the machinery. These are all example relating to the capital expenditure. Then we are going to learn about revenue expenditure. Capital expenditure, which is a non-recurring in nature, but revenue expenditure is a recurring in nature. It is non-recurring in nature, it is recurring in nature. Capital expenditure, which is incurred to increase the profit earning capacity of the business, but revenue expenditure incurred to run the business. It is incurred to run the business. Here we are spending money to run the business, not to increase our profit. Okay. It intended to benefit current accounting period. It intended to benefit current accounting period only. Then it has useful years of life. Its benefit we can consume within a year. Then it possesses a scrap value, but it do not possess a scrap value. For this example, for revenue expenses, example, salary paid, rent paid, commission paid, discount received, repair, carriage on goods purchased, then legal expenses. Students, carriage on goods is a revenue expenditure, but carriage on purchase of fixed asset is a capital expenditure. Then purchase of goods, expenditure incurred on purchase of goods. These are all example for revenue expenditure. The revenue expenditure are called expenses. Revenue expenses are called expenses debited to trading and profit and loss account. Students, revenue expenditure are considered to be expenses debited to the trading profit loss account. Then what about capital expenditure? Capital expenditure are considered as asset. It will appear in the balance sheet. Next, we are going to study about deferred revenue expenditure. deferred revenue expenditure. Students, capital expenditure, the value of expenditure is heavy, heavy expenditure. Capital expenditure is a heavy expenditure. Capital expenditure is a heavy expenditure, but revenue expenditure is a heavy revenue expenses. It is called heavy revenue expenses. It is in between capital and revenue. The capital expenditure value is heavy, revenue expenditure value is very small, but deferred revenue expenditure is heavy revenue expenses. Okay, it is also non-recurring in nature. Deferred revenue expenditure also non-recurring in nature, which is incurred to increase the profit earning capacity of the business. It has useful years of life. It intended to benefit not that several years, it intended to benefit only few years, say 3 to 4 years. Students, what is deferred revenue expenditure? It is a heavy revenue expenses which is non-recurring in nature, which is incurred to increase the profit earning capacity of the business. It has useful years of life, which intended to benefit only few years. It will appear in the asset side. It will appear in the asset side of balance sheet. It do not have scrap value. Example for deferred revenue expenditure is, example for deferred revenue expenditure is, one, amount spent in order to introduce a new product in the market. New product in the market. That means advertisement expenses incurred in order to increase a new product in the market. Then research and development expenditure. Research and development. Development expenditure. These are all example for deferred revenue expenditure. Students, in this class we learned cash inflows and outflows. Inflows deals with the receipt, outflow deals with the payment. But in this class we discussed about cash outflows. The outflows are three types. One is capital expenditure, revenue expenditure, and deferred revenue expenditure. In next class, we'll learn information relating to the cash inflows. Till then, bye and thank you.